Hello makers, today I'm building a simple IoT switch with an ESP8266 on a Node MCU board and a relay. But let's see why I definitely need this switch. Well, this is my current workbench. Next to it are some boxes, my very own IoT lamp, my gaming console, and some other IoT projects. Those things don't need to run all the time. So I have a switch. And here it is. Behind those subwoofers. Can see the light? Yeah. It's pretty a pain in the to reach it. It's quite annoying, let's say this. So what would be better than building an IoT switch where I can control power to all those devices with any mobile device? Well, I worked those relays several times, but never in combination with those ESPs. The only problem I see, I'm pretty sure the signal on this relay needs to be 5 volts, which the ESP can't deliver. It works on a 3.3 volt basis. Maybe I have to add a level shifter, which would be pretty bad because those level shifters aren't very cheap and I haven't got a level shifter that only shifts one pin. It always shifts about 4 or 5 pins. It would be kind of a waste. I guess I have to check if the signal line of this relay also works with 3.3 volts. What would be the easiest way to do this? I have one of those breadboard power supplies. And you can switch those from 3.3 volts to 5 volts for those power rails. And luckily I have two of them. I'm pretty sure the relay has to be powered by 5 volts, so let's add 5 volts. These are the power lines. White is ground, red is positive. And another pin for the signal line, where you can attach this signal line to 3.3 volts on this rail. But this won't work right away, because they need also common grounds. So we bridge the ground line from both power rails and see if it does a magic trick. On this power rail we have 5 volts. On this we only have 3.3 volts. I connect the signal line to 5 volts. You can see the relay reacts as it should. Let's check if it also works with 3.3 volts. It does indeed. So I'm pretty sure it also will work with this ESP module. I bought one of those enclosures for wiring for basements example. It has water protection and is suitable for electrical wiring. I won't put it in the basement or in other places with high humidity, but they are much cheaper than rebuilt project boxes and easier to handle than printing your own box 3D printer, which I don't even have. Made a PCB where I can easily fit those USB. And all I have to do now is adding power and the relay. So let's do it. So I prepare the box. A hole for the USB cable. So now I can solder it to my pre-prepared PCB. This is all we need the in and ground. I marked all ground pins with a black marker. Lucky me, I got a job where no soldering is required. Because I think I would starve to death. Using some Dupont wires as connectors for the relay. A brown wire will be ground. And the orange one should be VCC. Let's check if I haven't made a closed circuit. Works fine. So now I must find a good position for the relay in the box. Oh, this might work. I can see which length to use. Well, which pin should we use? I guess we go for the classic D2 pin, shouldn't we? Yep. Quite nice. Now we need the hot wire for it. So next I found a power strip that I can use. I will cut this cable and put the relay in between. Something I forgot. Oh yeah. This is a warning. Power from the power line can kill you. It doesn't matter if it's 110 volt, it's 230 volt, even 50 volt AC can kill you. So please, don't try this yourself. It's very, very dangerous. Even if all those steps I'm doing here, there's always something that can go wrong. You aren't a professional. You risk your life, you risk the life of your family and your neighbors. So please, if you aren't an electrician or really know what you're doing, please don't do it. I leave this sign here while I work on this project because playing with microcontrollers should be fun and not dangerous. Dirty old thing. Cutting in between. So it's very important to add those caps. You ask yourself, are those caps really necessary? Here's a picture. What could happen if you forgot those caps? First of all, the ground connection. This ground we shouldn't connect to the Arduino. And because we use a plastic case, we don't have to ground this plastic case. Next, we connect the neutral line again. And the only reason I'm using different colored connectors, because they are the only ones I've left lying around here. And this is a phase. Okay, those two pins are connected when this relay don't receive a signal. The other two are only connected to each other if there is a signal. So we are using those pins. Not much room in here. So let's check if we don't create any short circuit. Okay, this must be the phase. Because I have no connection through. Yeah. Looks good. Perfect. And the neutral line. Okay. Looks like we have no short circuits. Nice positioning. And let's see if you can program it. While you program it, you shouldn't connect anything to the Node MCU board other than the USB connector. Because some of those connections can interfere with the programming process. So we are done programming it. And let's run a naked test. No, not I'm naked. Let's add a button. Let's name it power switch. Topic of ESP3 power in. Yeah, I have a fable for long names. Yeah, it's a good symbol. So, save it. Let's see if this one does a magic trick. Ah. Yep, it works. Well, the code walkthrough would be similar to the MQTT NeoPixel Stripe. I'll leave an info box here. You can check it out, and I'll leave the code to this one down in the description. Have you forgotten anything? Indeed, we have. The fuse of my power line is rated 16 amps. This relay only is rated for 10 amps. So I have to add a fuse, 10 amp or less, to the circuit to protect the relay from burning out. And I should really mark the power strip with those 10 amps, just to be sure. Max 10 amps. Well, I will still add this, we'll add a 10 amp fuse to it. Maybe less. So before I put it away, because I don't have a 10 amp fuse at hand, I will do a live test. But remember, don't do this at home. Your power line is dangerous. You can kill you, your family, your cat. Well, another simple IoT project with some of the easiest components you can find. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more IoT projects, leave it in the comment. Share, subscribe, be creative, and bye.